The wrestling industry is going through this great change, and the right side of history is the side that we're on.
We want to do something that nobody else has really done, like, or at least in years. Like, when's the last time you heard a story about this? You know, three guys self-financing a huge arena show. Like, it hasn't happened.
A company outside of WWE, get 10,000 people. We got to do this right. This is unheard of. The bet, David said, that currently he didn't think ROH could draw 10,000 fans.
For the last 3 years, the attendance was growing a lot, and Matt and I, we said, man, maybe one day we could fill an arena up, and Cody pretty much said, yeah, we can. Let's do it.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much how it came about.
I love Cody because he's very similar to us. Like, he has this fire that's lit under his ass.
Yeah.
We love wrestling. We love the business. We're constantly talking about the business. He eats and breathes and sleeps it.
He's the most passionate wrestler I've ever met in
right.
my life.
It's fun for me because this is scary new territory for us, but it's like, man, if we have Cody with us, I think we can do it. Like, he makes you believe, you know what I mean?
I say this all the time, Matt and Nick are the most old school wrestlers of the current generation. They're doing something different, and it's cool to be around, and their energy is infectious, and they're cowboys, and there's not a lot of cowboys left in wrestling. So you want to be around that. I felt that I was becoming undesirable in this wrestling world, especially in the last few years I had with WWE. And then all of a sudden, it's like the fire lit. I got very lucky with the places I walked into and the people that I ran into, particularly Matt and Nick.
People treat us like the gateway between WWE and Indies. Whether you're going to WWE or you're coming back to the Indies, we're the gateway, we're the bridge. I didn't know much of Cody besides what we all
besides
knew about.
Besides Kevin Steen, Kevin Owens, and said, hey, Cody's leaving. You guys are gonna love him, and please help him out on the
Indies.
To
take care of him. And when a guy like Kevin says, hey, you're gonna love Cody, we take it seriously. We go, okay, let's love him then. We meet him and...
right away, we hit it off.
Yeah, right away, we became buddies with him. Everybody wants to help out now. It's funny, it's like, everybody's like, let me in, let me in.
The biggest names in wrestling have already contacted us
yes,
about being a true. Part of it. It's gonna be big.
Obviously, the Being the Elite cast is going to be involved in, you know, some shape or form.
Kenny Omega for sure will be a part of it. We're talking to some big name Japanese guys that
yes.
want
to
be a part of
it. Who already committed to us. Cody's probably already mentioned them, right? Should I spoil that?
Well, let's not name names.
Well, he's got a show on the CW, so he's I think he'd be interested.
And I think fans know it's going to be a big deal,
yeah.
and they're going to want to be a part of history because there's only one first show. If it's sold out, it might be the biggest thing we've ever done.
Yeah, if it's successful, it might be one of the biggest things we've ever done, right? It seems impossible, really,
yeah.
right? Like, oh, who do these guys think they are? Like, oh, these guys with the arrogance, they think that they could fill a 10,000-seater?
Yeah.
It's like, that's the thing about our career, though. Everything's always been a calculated gamble and a risk.
Yeah.
Everything in our career could have gone
this
wrong.
This will be a risk, but you know
yeah.
what? It's going to be so fun to do it.
Yeah, you
know
it will be.
I love wrestling, so it's always been cool to me. It's just... growing, but it's growing differently. It's not a Monday night cable war. It's so accessible to find your favorite wrestlers wherever they may be, whether they're with WWE, whether they're with Ring of Honor, whether they're with Lucha Underground. So that accessibility has led to this just resurgence of it being cool. And I'm glad I can have that. You know, I see Bully Ray down there and he's lived through the Attitude Era. We haven't had our Attitude Era. You know, we want our own era.
I should announce it.
September 1, 2018, Chicago, Illinois. We're coming.
We're going to do it. We're in absolutely zero fear about it. All in. Are you all in?